By the time the St. Lucia Fire Service responded, what started as a few sparks had developed into a full-blown fire.
I was on the cash, and by the time I cashed to punch in a meal, the machine stopped. So by the time I called the boss, I said, "Miss Christine, come and check the machine for me." She says, "The transformer." But a customer did want some juice, and I go through the bar to get the drug or juice to come and serve the customer. When I go, I check the breaker, having smoke, and I rush out one time and call the boss. Same time I take my phone and say 911, the fire truck. They tell me don't panic, give them my name and number. But when the first truck come, it didn't come with no water. So that's where everything get loose. That's where, because you see, if they went come with water, the local fire that was in the breaker, maybe it would control, it wouldn't bring out so much.
I was just cashing a meal and I go by the fridge to pour juice out and I just see the fridge cut off. So I call she and I tell her that. And when she goes in the bar to take a Morbi, she come and say, "I'm firing the breaker." That's it.
What did you do?
And I run out, everybody run out. We leave our bag, my phone, everything. All my clothes upstairs, burn my shoe. I need my phone. I don't have my phone now.
Confirmation of how the fire started also came from a customer who had gone to the establishment to purchase lunch.
When I got there, I just saw like the breaker. I think I heard the breakers making noise and what have you, like some loud noise. I saw all the ladies start running out, like ladies serving the food. So they said, "Well, boy, it was some electrical trip or whatever." So I told them, "Well, go back inside and turn off the breaker because I know the people breaker and what have you, you know? I know where it is." Nobody did. Everybody just ran out and it just kept on going and going and going until it started into flames. But it started as some little smoke coming out from the roof. And afterwards, it just turned out into some big flames.
Others could only watch helplessly as the intensity of the flames increased.
My friend and I was just there having a seat and we were just there. And we noticed sparks, but we didn't really bother that. And then we noticed, you know, we started to see the sparks and then I noticed it get a bit serious. So I don't know exactly what was going on. Then we noticed the place start to burn and yeah, that's about it, you know, yeah.
I live right over here in Rodney Bay by Spinnaker's. And I was driving past and the flames had just started in Triangle. And there was maybe four or five people scrambling, but I went into Super J and turned around to see if I can come back and help. By the time I got back, the whole thing was in flames.
The fire gutted the Triangle restaurant and pub and resulted in some smoke and water damage to the adjoining Rituals Coffee House. The owner of the Triangle stood a short distance away, obviously distraught.
I really don't have anything to say at this time. I don't know what's happened. I'm just called to the area at this point. That's all. I'd rather not comment on anything further.
Nothing much was salvageable from the burnt-out building, except perhaps a few pieces of chicken that were still being roasted on a slow fire close to where the real fire was being fought. But then again, no one obviously had the appetite to eat them. For the DBS News World, Pete Ninvalle reporting.